Now, you should know that all of these Yelp reviews and restaurant responses are 100% real. These are real deals.
All right.
So for each of these, I'll be playing the customer. Aziz will be playing the restaurant's owner. Here's the first one. Can you change the lights? And James, can we get some dinner music, maybe? Something? Oh, no. I won't be recommending this place to my friends. I'm only giving you 1 star.
Not recommending this place to your friends is a purely hypothetical situation. First, you'll probably need friends. Then, second, you'll have to be likable enough for them to visit you in Denver. I hope we can survive without your theoretical friends visiting our establishment.
Ouch! Here's another one. Here we go. Sorry. Is your pasta made with eggs? I'm allergic to eggs.
No, there are not eggs in our pasta.
How can you be so sure?
Because I made the pasta myself without eggs.
And nobody else would have thrown some eggs in it?
Oh, yes. Now I remember. Yes, we had a crazy guy yesterday in our kitchen throwing eggs all over the place. And yes, he may have thrown some eggs in the pasta too. Who knows?
Really?
Not really.
Yeah, I remember the crazy guy throwing eggs. Let's do another one here. We have dinner music, please. This one is insane, man. Never go again. Worst service. I went there for happy hour, and they charged me 2 drinks while I only ordered 1 happy hour drink. I asked the bartender. He said he didn't have the right to change the bill and asked me to call the manager later since he's out. I called, and they just said the manager's really busy and will call me back. As you can figure, no call at all. 1 star!
Hi, Emma. First of all, a manager did call you back, left a message, and you chose not to return that call. We spoke to both bartenders, and they are both confident you did, in fact, have 2 happy hour drinks. You aren't hard to forget, considering you lost control of your bowels in the middle of our restaurant, and you proceeded to sit in it for the remainder of the evening. We had to reroute our other patrons so they didn't walk through your mess, causing quite a scene. You then proceeded to throw away your underwear in our trash can. We'd be happy to refund your entire bill with the understanding you will never return to any of our establishments until you are potty trained.
How is that real on any level?
I gotta say, pretty chill place to let her get another drink after she soiled herself.
We have time for 1 more.
Okay.
And here we go. Thank you for doing this. Here we go. We walked inside this place twice. Once when it was a sushi bar, then again after it pathetically pivoted to meet the poke fad. And it stunk on both visits. The door was too spring-loaded on our return. That's first off. And the food was mediocre at best for the standard $11 plus tax. 1 star.
We were taken aback by your use of the word pathetically in your comments about us pivoting our business model. When you mention the word pathetically, we can't help but visualize you sitting in front of your computer or phone crafting over 7,500 Yelp reviews. We did some quick math, and based on an average review time of 8 minutes, could be conservative, you have spent around 1,000 hours writing reviews. That's nearly 6 months of a full-time, 40-hour-per-week job writing reviews that you are not being compensated for or improving to any sort of skill set. Our suggestion to you is to get away from this dark, dark rabbit hole you have jumped down. Just think about the fact that you have spent nearly 6 months adding zero value to your career. Start putting the same effort and focus on a craft or skill set that'll get you away from your social network and start working towards career goals that will bring you happiness and fulfillment. And be sure to stop by next week to try our all-new wasabi shrimp poke bowl.
Be sure to stop by the way. That's all the time we have for dramatic Yelp reviews. Our thanks to Aziz Ansari.